A new federal program to help lower the cost of broadband service to families across not just Chautauqua County, but the nation now underway. Here locally, Chautauqua County Executive PJ Wendell met last week with mayors and town supervisors to discuss the emergency broadband benefit. He joins us live now on the program to talk more about how it will increase accessibility in places like Jamestown. Thank you for joining us today.
Well, thanks for having me.
First off, how much money is available and what specifically is this funding supposed to cover?
Well, there's several billion dollars available nationwide. As a member of the IAC, Intergovernmental Advisory Committee on Broadband and Telehealth, we were made aware of this and realized that the monies were still there and actually quite underutilized. So again, we wanted to make sure that residents of, you know, not only Jamestown, but surrounding areas were made aware of this. I know in several meetings we've had with Mayor Sundquist, his concern was for the affordability of internet access, especially in the city of Jamestown, but also, you know, in our metropolitan areas outlying, you know, the villages of Falconer, Lakewood, Celeron, Fredonia as well, but also the city of Dunkirk. So I think this program is readily available. Again, very much underutilized, and encourage everybody to, you know, reach out. When you hear the qualifying criteria, this is available for a great many people here in Chautauqua County.
Yeah, and that's my next question is, how can families take advantage of this funding? Is there a specific place that they would need to apply to?
If you go to getemergencybroadband.org, there's an application online, and find the participating providers near you. And after you apply, you'll then be contacting a participating provider to select an eligible plan. If you need to, you can call 1-833-511-0311. Again, 833-511-0311. But also to, you know, go to that getemergencybroadband.org, you know, through the FCC. I was at an intergovernmental council that we've started now between Ohio, Pennsylvania, and Chautauqua County here along the Lake Erie shoreline. And Pennsylvania has tapped into this greatly already. So, yeah, we want to make sure that as we got the information from the FCC during my meetings with them, then, you know, make it available and affordable to our residents.
Yeah, and that was actually my next question, is the fact that the money isn't just limited to those here in Chautauqua County, New York State, but elsewhere. I know we have some viewers in Pennsylvania. They are able to take advantage of this as well.
Correct. This is it's a nationwide program, and we encourage everybody, you know, especially with the affordability of internet, this would be a means for families to qualify to have it a little bit more affordable and not such a burden on their monthly household expenses.
Yeah. And I know you have been pretty vocal in trying to get internet access, A, affordable, and B, in some places, just to implement it. What role did you have in securing this funding and advocating for the internet accessibility here in our area?
Well, the funding has been made part, you know, made in part by the FCC, but it's through that the IAC committee that I'm on that, you know, expresses our concerns and need for broadband. You know, some of us remember 20, 30 years ago, maybe now, that, you know, the internet was still, you know, when you went on, your family landline was busy, and, you know, you got a monthly bill based on the minutes that you were on the internet. Now it's become, as we've all said it, you know, this is far and wide. You know, the president and chairman of our committee is from Sioux Falls, South Dakota, and they'll tell you that whether it's Sioux Falls, Chautauqua County, you know, anywhere amongst our representatives, that, you know, broadband has now become essential. You know, this isn't a matter of an option or even a luxury, but it's really essential service when it came to. We saw that last year during the school year. Places I know I've heard of, you know, having to put a hotspot in school buses and driving out to remote parts of our county or neighboring counties to provide that service. So, you know, my goal has been in my administration to get broadband throughout Chautauqua County, where currently we don't have these connections, but also to enhance the services and make it affordable for those who qualify in our metropolitan areas. So, you know, we were instrumental in giving our feedback and making sure that, you know, the funding then becomes available to all those who are eligible.
Yeah, there is that two-pronged push when you look at it, the affordability for people who already have it, say in Jamestown, Falcon, or Lakewood. But then as you go farther out, I know there are parts of the town of Bus-Stuy, you know, Panama, some rural areas where, yeah, you can get internet access, but it's very, very poor. And as you mentioned, during COVID, people needed to get online. That's still continuing today, people struggling to make that connection. Is there anything that this funding or something else could be used to try to expand that connectivity across the rural areas?
Well, certainly, Justin, if you remember, you know, part of our ARPA funding, we've allocated $2.5 million, which is, you know, a small amount, but again, we'll increasing as the need arises. To get that that broadband out to those communities who are underserved. You know, we've met with Windstream, we've met with DFT Communication. We have a great deal of coverage now, but how do we expand that coverage and make it affordable to everyone? And you know, there's a lot of different possibilities as far as connectivity, you know, whether it's fiber line to the house in some instances or to a you know, Wi-Fi transmitter where we can get it, you know, through Wi-Fi to the homes. But you know, we are working together, partnering with our providers, getting this out to our residents. So, and as we go through, again, one of the pieces that I've been, you know, pushing through in my administration is, you know, the quality of life. And we're looking at more and more people leaving those larger metropolitan hubs of New York City and Pittsburgh and Cleveland to an area like Chautauqua County and our, you know, beautiful area that we can relax in, but also be able to work remotely. So the more we can provide, the more we have people living in Chautauqua County, providing, you know, the tax base, in sales tax revenue, et cetera, but working in somewhere like the Pacific Northwest or the Midwest or even, you know, the West Coast and being able to travel, you know, quarterly or monthly as needed. So I feel, you know, this is one of the tasks we started way back when we first heard of, you know, infrastructure funding, you know, in the form of, you know, what the ARPA funding came as. If you remember, they really focused on water, sewer, and broadband. When ARPA was first discussed, it really wasn't even ARPA. It was just called a rescue plan or, you know, state federal funding. But along with this, now we also have the infrastructure bill that, you know, they're trying to pass in Washington. So again, should that those monies be allocated and start to, you know, expand, then we could use what the ARPA money for other projects and focus infrastructure projects, monies rather, on these infrastructure designated projects. So it's a win-win for everybody in Chautauqua County, but it is a commitment of my administration to, you know, move forward and get more broadband and expanding that throughout the county.
Yeah, so I know that the legislature voted on that to move forward with the ARPA plan. We're almost sort of have to stay tuned for that infrastructure to see what else we could get. But final moments we have here together, what is next in that process of actually saying, okay, let's come up with a plan. Let's work with, say, somebody like DFT or Windstream to try to roll out better connectivity and for some just connectivity in general.
Well, so we've sat down and met with both. We have a broader expansion of DFT's plan and how much it covers. We have to sit down again with Windstream. They're a larger group, so takes a little bit while, you know, a little while longer to get the information back. So when we do that, what's unique about this is the county is involved in expanding a process where we won't have any assets at the end of the expense of our funding. And for example, when most things that we do in the county, if we're going to expand, let's say, you know, our radio service, we have towers, we have hardware, we have mobile units here. We're investing in something that we don't have those tangible assets, you know, under the county's, you know, purview. So a unique situation. It's something new to the area, but something we're definitely committed to. So we're going to sit down and continue to work. As you'll hear on Wednesday, the ARPA funding is start, the resolutions have come in. And, you know, we put the infrastructure plans on the second tranche of money, that, you know, second $12.3 million, in the hopes that we would have an infrastructure bill coming out of Washington with a little bit of clarity so we know where we can utilize infrastructure monies for and where the ARPA funding can be turned around and put into other programs.
Yeah, so certainly we'll stay tuned for updates. Chautauqua County Executive PJ Wendell, thank you for your time.
Thanks so much, Justin.